Every good spy needs a cover. Be a journalist, I said. You're good with words. You'll be safe.
Where's the cover, Mr. Soames? Hmm? Freeze the girl. Sleep.
I'd like to call the American consulate and tell them where I am.
They've already been informed. Someone's coming to pick you up.
It might be them.
Last time I spoke, I didn't realize how fond of Mrs. Lanting you were. If I'd known, I'd have been more careful what I said.
Both the Lantings are friends of mine.
But only one of them accompanied you to your hotel last night.
Yeah. She came to tell me she was still in love with her husband.
I'd be careful. It isn't in some people's nature to love us back. Mr. Soames.
I don't know.
I have no idea. Where is she?
A friend of mine told me Shanghai was the Paris of the Orient. Due to an international treaty, every nationality under the sun lived within her borders. Chinese and English, French, Japanese, American. My friend said you could travel the world in an afternoon and never leave the confines of Shanghai's international settlement.
Seems like Shanghai's gonna be a bit of a come down for you after Berlin, Mr. Soames.
Not from what I hear, sir.
You meant as a journalist, not a bad shot.
Well, if Japan doesn't withdraw from China soon, Roosevelt threatened to get his hands dirty, so I'm sure there'll be plenty for me to write about.
Ah. You think it's a good idea for your country to join the war?
Well, not if it means fighting you Germans. You seem to be pretty good at it.
I'm sure nothing to pick.
Did you have to provoke him?
I thought you said he was a diplomat.
No, I said he was attached to the consulate.
No. Will I ask the consulate?
It's an engineer.
Shanghai was about the only place left in China the Japanese hadn't taken over. Everybody knew it was only a matter of time before they swallowed it whole. Officially, the guerrilla war between the Chinese and the Japanese was none of our business. So, like a good American, I kept my head down and remained neutral. Shanghai was divided up into sectors. Drink in the British zone. Eat in the French zone. Spy in the German zone. But stay the hell away from the Japanese. Naval intelligence had sent me to Shanghai to help out an agent who was in trouble. He was my oldest and best friend. His name was Connor.
Thank you.
get you out tonight. Casino. In Shanghai, things change pretty fast. The routine with Connor was always the same. We'd meet in the biggest casino in town. Loser would buy dinner.
Something for your taxi home.
It's a short walk to my hotel. Three nights.
Three nights, thank you.
Captain Astor sent me.
We finally got you out of Berlin.
How's your trip?
Glorious. Except half the Gestapo was on the ship with me.
Come on in, let me get you a drink.
Who the hell's Connor? He's supposed to meet me at the casino.
Found earlier in the Japanese sector. I guess he was on his way to meet you.
You know, this whole country has its head buried in the sand. The Germans are getting ready to march into Europe, and all we care about is whether or not the Yankees beat the Giants. I mean, what have we done with our lives? I called Naval Headquarters this morning. I volunteered as both for intelligence.
Connor and I had joined the Navy like our fathers and grandfathers before us. Our lives were set. Birth, school, Yale, war. The great American tradition.
He was investigating a local gang lord called Anthony Lanting. He's the boss of the Shanghai Triad. He has a deal with the Japanese. They leave him alone, and whenever the Japanese need any dirty work done, they go to him.
I'd like to read all of Connor's reports.
He hadn't briefed us in a month. That's why I sent for you. I was under a lot of pressure to have him reassigned.
Why?
Because the situation here isn't just black and white. You've got the Chinese fighting the Japanese. Us, we're caught somewhere in the middle. And the truth is, the Japanese want to walk in our zone. There's nothing we can do about it. So sometimes our only option is just to sit back and not rock the boat. And that wasn't Connor's style.
The informers?
Yeah, he's got a contact at the Japanese consulate, a diplomat called Kita. We've already spoken to him.
I'd like to speak to him myself. I need an introduction to Lanting.
Apart from his own people, he only mixes with the Germans and the Japanese.
I know plenty of Germans. When do I start at the Herald? In Berlin, I played the part of a journalist with Nazi sympathies. And I was doing it again at the Shanghai Herald.
Mr. Soames was the Washington Post's correspondent in Berlin before he joined us. I'm sure most of you are already familiar with his reputation. Those who aren't will have a chance to find out for themselves in good time. Right. Back to work.
How's it going, boys? Paul Soames, Shanghai Herald.
Yeah, we set to meet with Connor's Japanese contact, Kita. You got a pen?
Where is it?
A place called the Bamboo Tea House in the Japanese district. He meets his girlfriend there every day at 3 p.m. And all clear. He'll open a book on the porch. Paul, listen to me. You'll be in the heart of the Japanese sector. You be careful over there.
Newspaper told me to hire you. I threatened to resign. The only reason I didn't was because I wanted to meet you face to face and see if you really believe this crap you write. My office.
Germany and Japan are no more our enemies than Britain and Russia are our friends. In a war of this magnitude, our only concern should be for ourselves. Japanese foreign minister met with a German foreign minister yesterday, and one of the subjects they discussed was whether my Jewish wife should wear a yellow star on her jacket and be herded into a Shanghai ghetto along with the rest of her kind. Now, I think that should be a concern for every civilized country in the world, even America.
I'm not a Nazi, if that's your implication, Mr. Sanger. I lived in Germany far too long to have any illusions about what kind of people they are. Now, you can fire me, you can censor me, you can do whatever.
I have no intention of firing you. Write something that doesn't make my stomach turn, and I'll print it. Otherwise, you can type your fingers raw for all I care.
Will that be all, sir?
Yeah, get out. Oh, and this came for you. At least your Nazi friends are impressed.
Hello?
Mrs. Mueller, thank you so much for the invitation.
Lovely to see you, Mr. Soames.
My pleasure. Mr. Mueller.
Mr. Soames.
A party at the German embassy can make one night feel like 1,000 years. Laughing at all their jokes is like eating breakfast from the gutter.
The way I see it, for America to join the war would be like a man who's never been in a relationship interfering in a 50-year marriage.
Thank you for a wonderful party, Your Excellency. I'm glad you're enjoying it, Mr. Nanty. You know everyone here, don't you?
Paul Soames.
Anthony Nanty. Gentlemen, excuse me.
These affairs had quite a guest list. Nazis, Japanese imperialists, the triads, Kepetai. They were all connected. Any one of them could have killed Connor. I had to get in between them. It was like being a worm, working your way into a rotten apple.
Please tell me you're not politicians or diplomats.
I should show you.
Because if you are a politician or diplomat, it doesn't matter how beautiful or charming you are. I just cannot talk to you. I couldn't bear it.
I'm afraid they can't speak a word of English, Mr. Soames.
No?
Let me introduce you properly. This is my cousins, Xinxin and Lily. And this is my friend, Captain Tanaka. A politician and a diplomat, I'm afraid.
Captain, it's a pleasure to meet you. I hope I didn't offend you, sir.
If there's anything else you'd like to ask the girls, I'd be happy to translate.
Well, now that I know you're related to them, I don't think that would be such a good idea.
Luigi.
Captain?
Japan is as deserving of an empire
in the East
as Germany is of an empire in the West.
So, how does the writer for the Shanghai Herald get honest to the German consulate?
Some friends invited me. Well, the truth is, I'm only friends with the lonely-looking Fraulein in the black dress.
Oh, I see.
A toast to the Emperor and the Führer.
Honorable men all.
And now, some music!
Anna. Darling, this is my friend, Paul Soames. My wife, Anna.
How do you do?
Pleasure to meet you.
What do you decide?
I thought we'd take them to the fashion show at the casino. So, how do you know my husband?
Actually, we just met.
Oh, I thought you were old friends.
It certainly feels that way.
Should I get you something to drink?
I'd like to dance before I do anything else. Will you dance with me, darling?
You should ask Mr. Soames.
Mr. Soames.
You're delighted. Thank you, Anthony.
You're welcome.
My husband doesn't always trust people he's just met. How did you charm him so quickly?
He and his cousins just seem like the most interesting people here tonight.
They're not his cousins.
No?
They're his mistresses. Anthony doesn't know I gamble. He'd be very upset if he found out.
I have no intention of telling him.
Good. Thank you.
I like secrets. I collect them.
Fascinating. Why were you following me at the casino?
I had no idea you were married. And who was your friend with a cigarette case?
A question for a question.
Well, it's like poker. I have to pay to see my hand.
What game are we playing, Mr. Soames?
Huh?
Mm.
Lenny.
I thought you'd left.
No. Lenny Mueller, this is Mrs. Anthony Lansing.
How do you live? I should get back to my husband.
Of course. Thank you for the dance.
Not at all. She doesn't look very merry.
Neither do you. Drop me off at the harbor.
Kito was Connor's only known contact. I figure if Connor trusted him, I probably could too. So I found us a quiet place to talk.
What do you want to tell me?
I was helping Connor. In exchange, he promised me an American passport. I was supposed to get it a year ago. He said it would help me.
Well, we're here to help. Keep talking.
Connor called me a few days before he died. He needed a checkpoint pass for a friend. His friend was Japanese. He was trying to smuggle out of Shanghai. He told me not to tell anyone. After he was killed, I was scared you'd think I'd set him up.
What'd you do with the pass?
I took it to the apartment in Taipei, like he said.
What apartment? Condom in the International Settlement.
He gave me an address in Taipei. When I went, there was nobody there. I can prove it. I still have the pass.
This was Connor's girlfriend.
Her name is Sumiko. I can show you where the apartment is.
So all Connor wanted was a checkpoint pass? Is he working on anything else?
Just routine naval intelligence. He had me report on the Empress East China fleet. He never told me what the information was for, and I never asked.
Just ask them if they ever saw one of the young... According to the neighbors, the girl disappeared the night Connor was killed. She set him up.
Must have rented another room, an attic or a basement. Anywhere could use this as a dark room.
So why didn't the girl hand these over when she turned them in?
Maybe Connor still had enough sense not to tell her everything. I saw this man with Lanting, the German consulate.
Yeah, his name's Tanaka. He's head of Japanese intelligence for Shanghai.
These are Navy and Air Corps officers here. I should find out who the other men are in that picture. Tanaka's saluting them. They've got to be ranking officers.
That's Lanting's wife. Her father was a respected politician until the Japanese took him out. They would have killed her too, but her family arranged for her to marry Lanting. He protects her.
Everywhere in the city. But she always seemed to be hiding something. So I did what you do with a puzzle. I stared at it until it made sense.
Couldn't shoot straight.
Even luckier that you were there. Who do I have to thank for that?
Fraulein I told you about last week. I was supposed to meet her at the fashion show and she stood me up.
Perhaps her husband sent those gunmen up to you.
Did you find out who they were?
I will. Captain, please come in.
Thank you.
don't you show Mr. Soames around the house until we are ready for dinner?
Do you know any of the men who died today?
They were Japanese.
And the others? I recognize your friends from the casino.
Why didn't you tell Anthony?
I wasn't quite sure what to tell him. Did Anthony know you were working for the resistance?
I'd never do anything to hurt him.
Friends didn't seem quite so discriminating. Murdered several men in cold blood. No one of them had survived. What will you do if he talks? Maybe I can help you.
Please! You're not a father! You're not a father!
You're not a father! You're not a father! You're not a father! You're
你以为我是谁啊？你刚才跟他吵架了？他可能以为有跟我分子在我身边。
他怎么会有这种想法？他们抓的其中一个杀手，还把了他一顿。我不知道他跟他们说了些什么。王八蛋，真你都不知道，一点面子也没有。Okay, was for speaking Chinese. How do you like the food?
It's sensational. In fact, it reminds me just how bad the food is at the Casanova.
The Casanova?
That's my local restaurant. I go there for the waiters. I dine alone each night, yet they insist on setting two places.
I'm supposed to meet a friend at the cafe later. He will lift back into town.
You're very kind, thank you.
You can't go into town tonight, darling. It's too dangerous after what happened.
I don't know how to reach her.
I'm happy to pass a message to her if you like, Mrs. Lanting. No problem at all, the cafe is on my way. Stop it.
I hope I can see you soon.
I look forward to that, Anthony.
Thank you for saving his life.
It seemed Anna wasn't worried about the Japanese coming after her. She was worried they'd find whoever was hiding under that hood.
Thank you.
I'm grateful for what you did.
Does that entitle me to a few more answers?
No. I've been doing some homework on you. I read your stories about the war in Europe. You write well.
Thank you.
But you don't seem to believe in much. The story you should be writing is what the Japanese are doing in Shanghai. The Japanese murdered thousands of people in Nanjing, and soon they'll do the same thing here. That's why we are fighting. You find this amusing?
No, I just remember a friend of mine.
In what way?
The way you argue. He was a force of nature. He'd come at you from all sides until you surrendered. So I should be writing about Captain Tanaka.
He already has hand in everything that happens in Shanghai.
Was he head of Shanghai intelligence when your father was killed? I did a little homework on my own. Sounds like he was a remarkable man. Must have taken a lot of courage to speak out against Japanese atrocities in Nanjing.
He just cared deeply about this country. Anthony loves American jazz.
Are you still in love with him?
I wouldn't be with him if I wasn't.
I only ask because you seem to be on your own a lot.
Our informants haven't found any information on the Japanese girl at the trade corner.
What about the men saluting Tanaka?
Well, they're officers from the aircraft carrier Kaga.
The Kaga?
We checked it out.
They were in Shanghai last month for R&R. There's nothing secret about it.
Look, Tanaka's in charge of security for visiting personnel. He's probably just telling them what bars they can and can't go to.
Connor wouldn't have taken pictures of it if it wasn't important. He was interested in Tanaka for a reason.
Paul, I know you don't want to hear this, but this profession catches up with all of us.
Maybe Connor made the wrong call.
He didn't make mistakes like this, Richard.
You know, the first article I ever wrote for the Herald was about your mother. Garbo of Shanghai, I called her. Now perhaps I'll have to dream up a name for you too.
Just finishing up some work back here, sir.
Why did you wait in my office?
She's a friend of the family. I'm helping her with her passport application.
I understand. I'll just finish up.
So if you just... Yes. Lock up when you go.
I needed to see Shanghai through Connor's eyes. The only port in the world that would take in 20,000 Jews on the run from Hitler. As the Japanese and the Chinese were engaged in street warfare. Dead bodies piled up. Westerners walked over them and went about their business. To survive Shanghai, he needed to understand her contradictions.
I showed these to the ambassador. He doesn't think that they warrant any form of protest. Having analyzed these photographs, I conclude that the SS methods for pacifying an occupied country are exceedingly simple. Families are picked at random, taken to a place of execution, and then forced to dig their own graves. And if they happen to be Jewish, then the children are shot in front of their parents first.
You're gonna beat the German army on your own? Forget the
Germans. We've already lost in Europe. Now, I'm talking about the Far East. The Far East, that's where the next battleground is. Now, we want to beat them, we're going to have to sink to their level. Do whatever's necessary. If our superiors don't like it, then they don't have to know. These sons of bitches have opened my eyes.
There's a lady to see you, sir, in the lobby.
Why didn't Carl take you with him?
What would I do in Tokyo? Drink tea with the wives? Try to understand their English?
If she would have told me you were coming, I would have canceled my dinner plans.
It's not what you think it is.
Of course it is.
Oh. I
put Carr through hell these past weeks. And men always seem to notice when you're not in love with them anymore. He's been so preoccupied with his work.
Bad day at the office doesn't justify that.
It wasn't a bad day. We've had the Japanese stay at our house ever since we arrived. Drinking our champagne, eating our caviar, and no word of thanks.
I'll say something.
It has to be nice to them. Our Navy sold them something that doesn't work. And now he has to fix it.
I didn't realize he was a naval engineer.
Can we please stop talking about it? What are you thinking?
I'm thinking about where to take you for dinner.
I thought you had plans.
Well, something came up. Would you like to join us? Would you like to sit down?
I'm meeting some friends.
Is Anthony with you?
Not tonight. My husband and I are having a party next week. We'd love to see you if you're free.
My pleasure.
Good.
Type 91 torpedoes, transferred to aircraft carrier cargo, October 28, 1941, Shanghai.
I don't even know what this tells us.
This tells us the officers of the Kaga didn't come to Shanghai for the nightlife. God, worked it all out. Look at the date. Torpedoes were delivered 2 days after Carr took his photos.
The Germans and the Japanese are allies. They sell each other weapons all the time.
These are not ordinary weapons. You got 800 kilogram torpedoes. You got naval engineers on both sides making adjustments to maximize the accuracy.
Let's suppose that he stumbled on an arms deal. What would you like me to do?
I know where the Kaga is.
I already did. She's been with the East China fleet the whole time. She hasn't moved. Months. I'll find out who killed him.
and I will do everything in my power to make them pay. But I can't declare war in Japan over these.
I hope I'm not crashing the party. I wasn't sure if you invited me the other night.
I invited Miss Mueller.
Mrs. Mueller. Did your friends ever show up?
You think I came to see you?
If I'm to be honest, I stayed up all night wondering if you did.
I'm wise to your charms, Mr. Soames. Oh? Don't forget, I heard you in action with Miss Mueller.
Mrs. Mueller. Listen. If I say something that offends you, please just smile and walk away because I would hate to get slapped in front of all your guests.
Maybe you shouldn't see it.
I want to see you again.
Are you flirting with my wife now?
Absolutely. How's your arm?
It's already healed.
I'm glad.
Dolly. We asked the girls to dance with our Japanese guests.
Okay.
Let's talk. A few years ago, I'd have cut his throat for even looking at her. Anna told me she saw you at the Casanova restaurant last Tuesday.
That's right, she did. She caught me having dinner with my German friend.
Will you confirm that to Captain Tanaka?
Of course. Thank you. Everything all right?
Japanese diplomats were assassinated that night. Captain Tanaka thinks someone close to me told a resistance was a fighter. He wants me to account for the movements of all my men.
Surely not your wife.
My wife? My friends? Myself.
Excuse me, Captain?
You're not enjoying the party, Mr. Soames.
You look like you're hiding out as well.
I'm too old to make a fool of myself on the dance floor. You're welcome to come in and hide with me.
We even have our own drinks.
Thank you.
I'm sorry. I was looking for my husband.
He's in the living room, I believe.
I've never seen so many men make fools of themselves over somebody. He talks to 10 of them at the same time, and they all think they are the only ones she's interested in.
Part of her charm.
You think it's as innocent as that? My husband tells me you spent Tuesday night with her.
No, not with her, unfortunately. I just ran into her at the same restaurant, the Casanova.
Are you married, Mr. Soames?
I was a long time ago.
My wife. Run off with another man 2 days before we were due to leave for Shanghai.
Sorry.
Did yours break your heart?
Well, I remember.
Women always win in the end. They forget us more easily.
Mine certainly did that.
Nobody ever making fools of us again. Do you think it's possible to fall in love like that again?
Well, I don't think it'll ever be as maddening as the first time.
I disagree. I think the second time might be worse for men like us.
What kind of men are we?
Romantics. We are so eager to get over the pain of the first betrayal. We walk blindly into the next. You don't remember how long Mrs. Lanting stayed at the restaurant?
If I can recall, she was there the entire time we were, about 9 to midnight.
The Chinese use these to light the alchemy candles. I'm always burning myself.
I think I will have one.
Fireworks. I told you.
Soon.
Yeah, I think so.
You were talking to Captain Tanaka.
Yes, we were both admiring your skill at convincing every man in the room that he meant something to you.
Surely that's what every good hostess does.
He seemed to imply there was more to it than that. In fact, he warned me to stay away from you.
Why would he do that?
He probably thinks I'm some idiot American who'd be crazy enough to lie for you.
Then, are you?
I think we both know the answer to that question. Thanks for the party.
This article reveals about, Mr.
Opium addiction amongst the various armed forces in Shanghai. Just take a look. Does he come here?
I wouldn't waste your time writing an expose on your Japanese friend, if that's what you're doing. He never touched the stuff. He only came here because of his little geisha girl.
Sumiko, wasn't it, Mikey?
Mikey here used to spy on them all the time. Even drilled his own little peephole through their private boo. Didn't you, peepo? She couldn't get enough of the stuff.
Is that the girl? When was the last time you saw them here together?
A few weeks ago. Nothing like Ralphie told you. I only peeped on them once or twice. And there was something sad about them. She'd lie there all doped out of her mind, and a Japanese friend would hold her hands, whispering.
Whispering what?
It came into his head. She was his future, his second chance.
Did you ever come in here with an American? Tall, good-looking, dark hair.
Oh, Mike, he's the only tall, good-looking American around here.
Felt like I was following Connor down a dark alley. Tanaka's mistress must have been off limits to anybody but a fool. Connor was a lot of things, but he wasn't a fool. Connor was investigating a ship called the Cocker before he died. You need to find out everything you can about her. Also, all the intelligence you have on the East China fleet.
No. They transferred me 3 times this month. I think they're testing me.
They're not testing you. Embassies rotate staff all the time. It's just precautionary. Just do this one more thing and we're going to get you out.
I need a second passport. That's all I ask. I'm getting married.
Well, give me a look at the cog and I'll consider it your wedding present. I'm going to arrange for the passports myself. The last thing you have to do for us. I have my word on that. The cog is not there. Here, take a look.
There are the ships missing.
Which ones?
The Akagi. It's a carrier. The destroyers and 2 tankers.
Is your list up to date?
It was dated the 1st of November.
Richard, we got 9 Japanese warships missing. You combine all these ships. And you have yourself a long-range attack formation. The destroyers protect the carriers. The tankers refuel them at the center. You got a fleet of fighter planes, each carrying 800 kilogram torpedoes. They're pulling ships from the main fleet, and we have no idea where they are.
I have a pretty damn good idea. I checked with our code-breaking units in Washington. None of these ships have been issued orders in the last month, which means they're probably back at their bases, undergoing repairs. They're hiding the fact that their ships are incapacitated. The Japanese delegation is in Washington right now, trying to negotiate a withdrawal from China. Our oil embargo has brought them to their knees. They're desperate to get any concessions they can out of us. The last thing they want us to know is that their fleet is underpowered.
I'm late for a meeting. We'll talk about this later.
Connor's been right every step of the way. And every time we doubted him, he's proved us wrong. We need to watch Tanaka 24 hours a day.
Maybe you should come to me sooner. I could have backed you up.
Same way you backed up Connor.
What is that supposed to mean? He was watching the Tanaka for weeks. For weeks, Richard. And he never told you a goddamn thing. Why is that?
Well, how the hell can I back him up if he wouldn't even talk to me?
Look, I don't want to believe that Connor died in vain any more than you do. But I can't ignore the facts. He fell in love with a Japanese spy, and she betrayed him, and that's all we got.
What if she was spying for us? We've always assumed she seduced Connor. What if it was the other way around?
You don't know that.
We know she was Tanaka's mistress. I think Connor found out about them while he was tailing Lanting. He saw an opportunity, and he took it, and he seduced the girl. That was everything Tanaka ever told her. Got back to Connor through her.
Even if you're right, she's probably dead.
Yeah, but if she's alive, she's on the run, I can find her.
Thank you, gentlemen. Meeting's over, Mr. Soames.
I need to speak with you, sir.
Make an appointment like everyone else.
I'm sorry, I just can't wait. I needed to smuggle someone out of Shanghai. Where would I go for documents?
Why are you asking me?
The young lady I saw you with the other night, you said you were helping her with her passport.
I didn't say I was doing it illegally.
I don't know any other way you could be doing it. The British and American consulate has stopped issuing papers. A friend of mine's in trouble with the Japanese authorities. I need to get him out of Shanghai now.
I'm sorry I can't help.
Maybe your wife can.
Are you blackmailing me?
Not unless I have to. I don't care what you think about me. Just turn these people down. Our lives are on your conscience.
Quite an impressive operation you got here, Billy.
Thank you. You can tell the war is coming to Shanghai by the number of faces on my wall. I have a waiting list of 300. You're lucky you're a friend of Ben's.
I know.
This one won't be convincing. She's not facing the camera.
Best I could do. Do you get many Japanese clients?
Mostly, the Japanese are happy to stay where they are. Why?
Oh, an old buddy of mine was trying to smuggle his girlfriend out of Shanghai. I was wondering if they came to you.
Everyone comes to me.
We keep records. I'd love to find this son of a bitch. He owes me a fortune.
I'm sorry. I guarantee confidentiality. You'll thank me for it yourself one day.
You take over when you're done?
Only if I don't find out why you were following me.
I wanted to see where you were taking the girl's passport.
Did you?
Captain Tanaka's mistress. Look, Anna. I followed your man to the safe house after I delivered your message to the casino. I actually saw him taken away. I didn't realize at the time because I'd thrown a blanket over her head.
你先出去一下。 Why are you interested in her?
She was also having an affair with a friend of mine, and he was murdered the night Sumiko disappeared.
We had nothing to do with it.
I'd like to hear that from her.
You're in no position to make demands, Mr. Soames.
Why are you doing it? Why would you kidnap her?
Tanaka has arrested hundreds of people. We are going to trade her for them.
Something you need to understand, Mrs. Lanting. Tanaka isn't negotiating. He isn't interested in getting this girl back. He wants her dead.
She wasn't just his mistress. She was spying on him.
Why should I believe you?
Because my friend is an American agent. Whatever it is she knows, Tanaka won't stop till he finds her. And when he does, he won't leave any of you alive to talk about it. Show me where she is. I promise you I'll do what I can to help.
I need more time.
You don't have time. She's in Shanghai. Tanaka's going to find her. No matter what you do, he'll be waiting. Do you understand?
I'll call you at your hotel this afternoon. Please. Don't follow me again.
I had no business thinking about her, but I couldn't help myself. I knew it was a mistake, but I remembered an old saying, the heart is never neutral. The Japanese were allowing only one train a week to leave Shanghai. I got the passports for Kita and his girlfriend, and I arranged for them to be on it. I was delivering on a promise made by Connor. Felt like the one decent thing I could do.
Oh,
Why didn't you call me?
My people didn't think they could trust you. We needed to move the girl.
You told them I'll smuggle her out of Shanghai and everything will work out fine. Is that it?
You don't understand.
It was quite a risk you took. She could have turned you in at any minute. Or did you tell your boy to shoot her at the first sign of trouble?
You had your chance. You followed me, not her.
What the fuck? Where are you supposed to meet with someone wrong?
There was no plan.
Bullshit! The girl didn't look too good tonight. From what I could tell, she could barely walk. What are they going to do to her when she slows them down, huh?
They won't hurt her.
Then they're probably going to get themselves killed. How many will that make it, Anna? Hey, you can play the heartbroken revolutionary all you want, and I'm not around. The truth is, you used everybody. Your friends, your husband, the girl, and for what? Tanika's still here, and your father's still dead. You want to bring him down? Tell me where she is!
You think that's all this is about? Thousands of people are dying every day. You think one life makes a difference? She can hardly speak. All she ever asks for is her opium pipe.
I just need to find out. I'll kill my friend.
Anthony, 是我, 你还没睡吧? 你先睡吧, 别等我了。 我还得等一会儿再回去。 我也爱你。
Who is it? Yes?
Captain Tanaka, would you like to see?
Has something happened? It's past midnight.
He apologizes.
All right, let's make it quick. Hey, hold it! Come back!
Wait here, Mr. Thompson.
Hope you know you're in violation of international settlement laws. You have no jurisdiction.
Husbands?
I'm sure if she wanted any of those things, she would have gone to you, sir, or her husband.
I'm sorry about these interruptions. It's an unfortunate business.
We arrested a spy last night. We arrested him on a train leaving the city.
His lover turned him in. She was a spy, Mr. Somers. You would admire her skills.
We did everything we could to break him down. Even when we put him face to face with the girl and she told him what she'd done, he refused to believe it. It's amazing how a man holds on to an idea, even when that idea is so obviously false. I suppose it's all we have to keep us going.
You're sure Mrs. Landing didn't tell you anything?
Send an official complaint to their government.
Where are we going?
To the hotel. We have to pack your things. There's a ship leaving Shanghai at 8.
Girl's still alive. I've seen it with my own eyes. I can find her.
It's too late. Even if she's still alive, there's nothing that you can do now. Your cover is blown. Tanaka won't give you a second chance.
Now what? Second chance? I want 24 more hours.
Please don't make this harder. Just get the hell out of Shanghai.
Sure, I can't change your mind.
Not this time.
You finally got sick of me, huh?
No. Are you kidding me? I just can't keep up with you.
It's because you're always watching my back. You know, as soon as I get there, I'm going to cause such a stir, they're going to have to transfer you. Christmas in Shanghai, old man. I'm holding you to that.
Set it up and then hurry. Thank you.
An unpaid bar bill.
Is there any other kind? Can I give you a hand with any of this?
We need to get to a hospital right now or she's gonna die.
I need you to wake up. I
need you to talk to me, okay?
You're my fool.
Just the way you do it.
你跟他一命抵一命。
First fleet on Pearl Harbor.
Now I go. The invasion of Shanghai is already underway. What did you think she'd tell you?
Why you killed my friend? You met with the officers of the cargo.
I heard about the plan to attack Pearl Harbor through my informants. I was never part of it. Yes, I killed your friend. I didn't even know he was a spy when I pulled out the night. I shot him in the dark.
我想问你太太这个问题。宁可以到我家？不行，就是你。我们不是已经想好了吗？我们不是在讲买卖，可是她是个太太。我们跟胡哥你走。啊？反正她从个地方也不跟你去。我们走，我会送她回来。
我会回来的，放心。
See you.
Europeans and Americans.
Thank you.
The port is now under... Please, stay calm, sir. The port is now under the control of the Japanese army. Foreign nationals will still be allowed to leave.
We left the house when we heard the first explosion. I was sure I had the passports with me.
Well, I can issue you with temporary passes. I just have to ask a few questions to satisfy the Japanese authorities.
So, what were you doing in China? I came to help a friend with his business. The business went bust. Unfortunately, I met my wife. I guess you start looking for something and end up finding something else.
And where do you plan to move after you leave China, Mrs. Fitzpatrick?
I haven't had much time to think about it.
在上海参加过政治组织吗? 中国人在为生存拼命。 为什么你要离开?
我离开是为了我丈夫，有一天我会回来的。
The world had changed, and it would never be the same. In Europe and in Asia, the cities were burning, and the hunters came out at night. And I got off the boat in Macau. I knew she'd go back to Shanghai. She worked with the resistance. Somehow, she stayed alive. Maybe luck, maybe courage. I had to have both. I know because I did the same thing in other cities under different names. Until the long night ended. But Shanghai haunted me. So I returned to her.
Thank you.
Thank you.